الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وتوفيقي ولا اعتمادي إلا على الله، عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا مثيل له، ولا نظير له بعلو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه. وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين، صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وخلفائه الراشدين المهديين من بعده وسرائه الكاملين العاملين في عهده، خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجليل، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين، أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. قال الله تعالى في كتابه المنزل على لسان نبيه المرسل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون. السلام عليكم brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us steadfast on the hadith of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On many occasions of khutbah, the khatibs, they follow the recipe of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ إِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وَأَحْسَنُ الْهَدْيِ هَدْيَ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا وَكُلُّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٌ وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٌ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. You hear this hadith إلى نهاية الحديث, until the end of the hadith. This hadith is a Prophet ﷺ used it often in his khutbah. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa was sadiq wal masduq. Salawat rabbi wa salamu alayhi. Everything he says is absolute truth. I am to find in heaven. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. We are not going to discuss this hadith except from the fact that there are now many different understandings of what this hadith implies. كل مهددة بدعة وكل بدعة في ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. And we have to see that ulama Ahl Sunnah, they have two masleks when it comes to bid'ah, innovations. They have two ways of, they've explained what innovation means. There is a maslak, ulama like Al-Izz bin Abdul Salam, bin Hajar al-Asqalani, and others, they said that this kul does not imply absolute every. It's not mutlaqa every. فيها تخصيص. There is a special kul. The Prophet ﷺ, when he was talking about the bid'ah, he was talking about the bid'atul madhmuma, al bid'ah that is blameworthy, that is not good, that is contradictory to the sunnah, contradictory to the kitab. And therefore, Al-Izz bin Abdul Salam, he has five categories of bid'atun hasana, good bid'ah. And Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani has two, bid'ah hasana wa bid'ah sayyi'ah, bid'ah madhmuma, innovation that is good and innovation that is bad. This is one maslak, this is one way of the salaf understanding of what bid'ah means. The second maslak upon which the jamhur ulama is that when it comes to language, the general meaning of bid'ah is innovation in a mutlaq sense, innovation. All innovations are bid'ah.
But when it comes from they made takhsis, that when it is used in a religious context, when it is used in a jurisprudent way, that bid'ah only signifies al-bid'atul madmuma, the bad bid'ah, the bid'ah that contradicts as-sunnah. Those are the two maslaks of al-sunnah wal-jama'ah, and they both agree, because both of them acknowledge that innovations of khair, of goodness, that when Muslims come out with new ideas to gather people on goodness or to motivate them to do goodness, that is according to the Kitab and Sunnah, that's according to the hadith of Sayyidina Muhammad SAW, that is bid'atun hasan. And they even, the second group does not even call it bid'ah, because for them bid'ah is only bad. Imam Shafi'i, is he from the Salaf al-Salih? He acknowledges this. He said, every bid'ah madmuma is the one that contradicts al-kitab wa sunnah. And a bid'ah that calls to khair is not that. And this hadith, why we don't also put it with another hadith about من أحدث في أمرنا هذا, حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها, whoever innovates in our amr, which is what our religion, our deen, who brings something new, completely contradicting what Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم taught, فهو رد, that is rejected. So he specified. Now it's not kul, every bid'ah, he specified which kind of bid'ah he's talking about, which kind of innovation he is talking about. ما ليس منه من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. The Sahaba understood the distinction. Sayyidina Umar رضي الله عنه وارضاه, when he went to Taraweeh and he saw one person praying by himself, 5 people, 10 people, the masjid was full of jama'ats, everybody's praying on their own, and he was with Sayyidina Abdul Rahman bin Abd al-Muqrib. He is the one narrating this hadith in Bukhari. What did he do? Jama'ahu ala qari wahid. He said, all of you tomorrow pray after behind one imam, Sayyidina Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu anhu. The Prophet never did this. And here Sayyidina Umar is bringing something new. And to make it even more clear that Sayyidina Umar understood the difference between bid'ah hasana and bid'ah sayyah, the next day he came to the masjid and he saw them all praying behind Sayyidina Ubay bin Ka'b. What did he say? نِعْمَةُ الْبِدْعَةِ هَذِهِ. What a good bid'ah this is. Sayyidina Bilal is praying the sunnah, the wudu prayer, the 2 rak'ahs of wudu. Prophet ﷺ said, I heard, سمعت خشخشتنا عليك في الجنة يا بلال. وكما قال النبي, I heard the sound of your sandals, O Bilal, in heaven. And he asked Jibreel. And he said, that's Bilal, that's المؤذن Bilal. And what did Sayyidina Bilal explain? He said, whenever I make adhan, I pray 2 rak'ahs. Whenever I lose my wudu, I make wudu, and I feel that I owe Allah 2 rak'ahs, so I pray 2 rak'ahs. After wudu, sunnah wudu, أصلحت يعني متبعة سيدنا بلال's way. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never sanctioned it. He never taught it to سيدنا بلال. And this, and what did سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم say? Oh brother, bid'ah, why are you doing something I didn't do? What did he say to him? He said, بهما, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بهما, with this new innovated way you are made, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is granting you, granting me to hear you in Jannah. بهما. Why? Because it is minhu. It is from religion to pray. It is from religion to be in jama'ah and pray together. It is from religion to make dhikrullah. It is from religion to gather people on salah ala nabi. Because Allah's order is make salawat. Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, plural, collective, make salawat. No, you can't make it in a group. No, you can't call people to make salawat. Why? This is the bid'ah, that understanding. We have to understand. The reason why I'm bringing this introduction, because next week we have a Mawlid. Rabi'ul Awwal starts. And you will see from the beginning of Rabi'ul Awwal to the end of Rabi'ul Awwal, people terrorizing Muslims online and in the masajid. And everyone, bid'ah, 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 bid'ah. You have better understanding than Sayyidina Umar of bid'ah, of Imam Shafi'i, of Al-Izz bin Abd al-Salam, of Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. We have better minds. We have to wake up and understand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding. Forget la mushaha fil istilah. People now are sensitive and allergic to the word mawlid. Mawlid? Oh, go to hellfire, mawlid. It doesn't matter what you call something. What is it that you're calling? If I call drinking alcohol, drinking tea, it doesn't make it halal. And if I call drinking tea, drinking alcohol, it doesn't make it haram. A cup of tea, if I say this is liquor, it is tea. It is not haram, just by calling it. So there is no point of arguing about the mustalah, about the word itself. What does it signify? Is it according ما ليس منه, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, or is it منه? Is it outside? Is it something contrary to the religion? Or is it from the religion? Which one is it? So let's see, what do people do in Mawlid? Here, when you come to IMO, they'll have a stage. Shaykh Abdullah Siraj will start with Holy Quran. Is the Quran min ad-din? It is minhu. Then they will make madih al-Nabi. Is al-madih min ad-din? Naam, Sayyidina Hassan bin Thabit. أجمل منك لم تر قط عين وأكثر وأكمل منك لم تلد النساء صلى الله عليه وعلى آله. كان he used to kiss him on his head and sit him next to him and pray for him that Allah supports him with Ruh al-Qudus. Is it from religion to praise Prophet? إنا أرسلناك واستعجلا إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا لتؤمنوا بالله ورسوله وتعزروه وتوقروه وتسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. تعزير النبي. Is it from religion? Respecting Prophet? Calling people to respect Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, to honor Sayyidina Muhammad. Is it from religion? Yes, it's an order. Ta'zir is to support him with tafkhim. Not just to support him, but with raising his status and showing how magnificent Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as a Nabi, as a Abdullah. ولكن خير خلق الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best of creation. من الدين. It is from religion. But what else they do in Mawlid? They play the deaf. That is something that irks people. But deaf, مذكور في السنة. جواري بني النجار والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الأعياد وفي في الأفراح when they were happy. He allowed it. What else they do? They feed people. طعام الطعام. أفشوا السلام حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. أطعموا الطعام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا الجنة بسلام. Feeding people. Making people happy. When people come to Mawid, they are very happy. The children come. There's food, there's dessert, there's candy, there's nasheed, there's salah ala nabi, there's Quran, there's community. What happens? You see, by the end of the night, everybody has a smile. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, idkhal al-sururi ila qalbi al-abdi min al-iman. Making people happy is from iman. Any one of these activities is not from our religion. Call it what you want. Don't call it Mawlid. Call it Majlis Ta'zim wa Tawqir al-Nabi. Call it what you want. As long as there's no activity in the Mawlid contrary to the Kitab and Sunnah, it is a good thing. اتقوا الله في أولادكم. Have taqwa. Your children are spending hours and hours and hours and hours on their devices, on nonsense, on even haram activities. And you bring them to learn about their Prophet, who is their wasila. Now, صاحب الشفاعة العظمى صلى الله عليه وسلم. Everyone one day will need سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. محبته إيمان. His love is equated to إيمان. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين صلى الله عليه وسلم. No إيمان. Your إيمان is not perfect unless you love that نبي. It's too much to bring them once or twice or three times a year to learn something about Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, or to give make salawat on him, or to feel happy. You want all their time to be learning about football players? This is عجيب, أمر عجيب. We have till 2. There's much to say about this topic. Because they, Ta'ifa in this ummah, have carried this bid'ah and takfir and tabdi' as a sword on the necks of Muslims for too long, scaring them away from a lot of goodness. And one of those goodness is Mawlid al-Nabi. Naam. Naam. Khayr kathir. Salah al-Nabi, istima' al-Quran, wadhikrullah. Khayr, goodness. They prevent people from doing. Why? Like the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Sahaba didn't do it. True. Why would the Sahaba do a Mawlid? For God's sake. Look, أعطوا المهج. They gave their lives improving their love for Sayyidina Muhammad. They need to do Mawlid. The companions need to do Mawlid. أعطوا الرخيص والغالي. ما خلوا شيء. في سبيل في محبة هذا النبي. In عشق for love of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. They gave their lives. They need to gather once a year from their busy schedule and come and say salawat. We need it. We need to remind ourselves.